Now, back to breakfast with Mark Parton, 1206.
CCC.
Where it is 11 to 9, every life's about choices. You have decisions that are made for you. There are many things that happen in your life that you have no control over. But there are so many other occasions where you get to choose. And I think for the most part, there's a safe choice and a bold choice. I think it's fair to say that on most occasions, we take the safe road because that's what we like. I've taken the courageous decision this time around. Doing this radio program, can I tell you, has been a great privilege for the past 7 years. And indeed, I would suggest to you it's a true privilege to be a broadcaster for the last 33 years. Radio is a beautiful, beautiful medium. It's instant. It's simple. It's broadcasting and publishing in its purest form. And I've loved every minute of it. Story's not over yet because, you know, I'm going to bounce back and do some stuff on this radio program. But when this new business of mine began to take off, I was faced with a difficult choice. It wasn't physically possible for me to keep on developing my business and to do this radio job in the manner that I think it deserves to be done. So at the end of the day, I really didn't have any other option but to call it quits because I couldn't just put the other one to bed. I couldn't. I have to mention this morning a good friend of mine, James Wilson. James is a fair bit younger than me, and I hope he doesn't mind me describing him as my business mentor. The whole idea of Parton Me was actually born from a simple conversation that James and I had one day outside the Canberra Centre, not all that long ago. And he told me why I should set up my own business, and I gave him all these reasons why I couldn't and why I shouldn't. And he went through all of those reasons and offered the solutions to each and every one of them. And I still walked away thinking, no, James, it's ridiculous. But eventually I sort of said, yeah, okay, let's give it a go. James provided me with my very first client, and he's continued to offer me enormous assistance in developing Parton Me to be what it is today. In the early part, James suggested to me on a number of occasions that one day, before too long, I would give up the radio and just do Parton Me. And I told him he was dreaming. I said, mate, seriously, that's never going to happen. I was wrong and he was right. I think we'd all like to jump out of the plane and try skydiving, but often we just don't have the courage and we don't have the self-belief to do that. So, James, thanks, mate. Couldn't have done it without you pushing me out the door. I will be forever thankful. Thanks to Graeme Cron for employing me here. Graeme Cron and Kevin Blyton and Pete Davidson, who were involved in that decision employing me here. That was back in 2008. Thanks to Jeff Fisher and Stephen Peed. Jeff Fisher will be listening. He'll be out there. They were responsible for employing me at Mix 106.3 way back in, 1999. Thanks to every single person who's listened to me on the radio at any point in the last 16 years. To every single business that's purchased advertising on any of my programs. Thanks to all of my producers, to Bodana Sidlick, Matty Mitchell, Jorian Gardner, David Shiraz, and Jeff Coop. To all of the fine news readers who've passed through here, including, there's a lot of them, Jane and Paris and Joey and Letitia and Ashley and Liam and Rachel, of course. I've missed some, but it's been a blast. And we're nearly done. Ryan's on the line. Hello, Ryan.
Oh, g'day, Mark. I just wanted to throw my name in there. I wish you all the best as well, my mate.
Good on you, mate. You've been a great supporter of mine, and I've loved all the messages and calls throughout the years. It's been good to have you on board.
Mate, I'm sure we'll cross paths again. I wish you nothing but the best for the future. Have a good Christmas to you and your family.
Thanks, mate. Brian's on the line. Brian Wilson from Canberra Painting Services. G'day, Brian.
How are you, Mark?
You're looking for some social media support, Brian. No?
I might have to come and see you, mate. Mate, just want to wish you all the best. And, sometimes us tradies are out there early in the morning and you send out a cheerio and we really appreciate it.
Oh, that's good, mate. That's good. It's, don't worry. The tradies and the taxi drivers and the bakers, they've looked after me over a long period of time. And I know there's always a squillion of them out there listening. So good to hear from you, Brian.
No worries, mate. Take it easy. I'm sure we'll speak to you in the future.
Shane Rattenbury's on the line, Greens MLA. G'day, Ratters.
Oh, good morning, Mark. I couldn't miss the opportunity to wish you all the best with the new career and thanks for all the interviews over the years.
I look forward to jousting with you on a bike path at some stage soon.
we should go for a ride sometime. But I should give you credit. You've coined the nickname Ratters for me.
Yeah.
And it's actually stuck.
Has it? Good.
Yes. Even my partner calls me that.
Is that right?
Yes, indeed. So I thought I should give you some credit for that one as well.
Excellent. Well, good on you, mate. Thanks for your accessibility over the time that I've been doing this. And you know, it's going to be a fascinating year ahead, isn't it?
Oh, it is going to be an amazing year. I think you'll be regretting not covering it in some ways.
Yeah. No, I'm not running, Shane.
The rumours continue to swirl, but I believe you that you've got a new business and I know you're working very hard on it, so
excellent.
Good luck with that
excellent.
As well.
Thanks, Shane.
All right then, see you.
Sean Carson is on the line from the Bureau of Meteorology. Now, Sean, I vowed and declared that you would be my final interview guest, and here we are.
Well, what a moment. I'll keep the tears back because I know I'm going to see you at the racetrack sometime soon, and you'll probably also ring me for track and weather conditions in the future.
I may well do. I may well do. Weather-wise today, it's going to be warm.
Yeah, 34 degrees. We've talked about the heat in Adelaide all week, and it's been a warm week in Canberra, but the heat is coming our way now. And 34 today, 36 on Saturday, 37 on Sunday. The Sunday comes with a bit of breeze as well. So total fire bans, isn't the countryside looking dry now? So a bit of a testing weekend for firefighters. The good news is the change is due, but not until Monday when it does come through. We're pretty hopefully getting some showers and thunderstorms when it passes through between Monday night and Tuesday.
Christmas Day is close, and there's all sorts of planning going on in terms of whether to go hot or cold. What's your advice for Christmas Day 2015?
Get down to the markets and put your seafood order in. It's looking like a warm one. I reckon about 30, maybe as warm as 32 degrees. Some chance of a storm in the afternoon, but I think we're finally due for a good warm Christmas, and it's coming our way.
Excellent. Good on you, mate. Thanks for all of your weather advice over the years, and I'll catch up with you again very soon.
Yeah, I've enjoyed chatting to you, Mark. All the best.
Sean Carson from the Canberra Weather Bureau. I think, ladies and gents, that I've said all I'm going to say. I think that's it. So, thanks, Jeff. Thanks to the crew in the newsroom. Let's get out of here. We are done and dusted. So, nothing more. I'll see you back on the radio, I think, in January for some casual shifts. We've rented a crowd to come in and clap for me this morning. Good on you guys. See you soon. Coming up to 9 o'clock. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. And always look on the bright side of life. Come on! Always look on the bright side of life.
Amber presents the case for living better, indoors and out.